Good afternoon, y'all. You're listening to Bedtime Reddit with Redtime Bedit. And tonight, teachers, what was your best excuse for being late that turned out to be true?
He told me that he got pulled over by the cops for wobbly driving on his bike, and they thought he was drunk. It turns out he was just dodging all the slugs on the street. Good man, watch out for the sluggies. They like to traverse the walkway in front of my house at night, so I always shine a flashlight so I don't step on them.
I'm an English professor, and one year, a pretty good student showed up without one of his two major term papers. He explained that his safe had been stolen by a contractor who was working on their house. His laptop was in the safe, and that's where his paper was. I genuinely believe him because he had been a really good student. Then, over the next few weeks, he started to show up to class looking very tired. He said that he had been on a hunt for the person who stole the safe, and he was spending late nights with his cousin driving around looking for the guy because they knew his van. Now, the student and his cousin were both recently back from tours in Iraq and had seen combat experience. They wanted to find the guy to beat him up and get the safe back because his wife's wedding ring was in the safe as well as a bunch of cash. He did rewrite the paper and turned it in, and he was apologetic that it wasn't up to his usual quality, and he still kept coming into class looking like he hadn't slept. After a little while, he came in very happy to my office hours, and he reported that he found the guy after a long search that involved breaking into a meth den and shaking people down with baseball bats and even bribing some prostitutes. He said that they found the guy's van at a Taco Bell after getting a tip from a prostitute, and they cornered him and waited for the police to come. I read in the news that he had in fact done a citizen's arrest and stopped the guy at a Taco Bell, and that they ended up calling in the Secret Service because he used the cash that he stole from the safe to buy a bunch of counterfeiting equipment. The Secret Service apparently investigates counterfeiting, so the whole investigation happened because this guy, who I dub the White Shaft, tracked down the scumbag through the bad side of town late at night to get a wedding ring, some cash, and his research paper back. It all turned out to be true. He got the ring and the laptop back, and I gladly accepted his original paper, and it got a much higher grade than the rewrite. I'm not a teacher, but I was training a new hire at a job, and the guy came in 45 minutes late, stating he got halfway to work and realized he didn't have his shoes on. It was the winter, and it was like 15 degrees outside. We had an exam in our class, and the teacher got a message from a student saying he was going to be late because his car had a flat tire. The student was known to party. The teacher didn't think it could be true, so as a joke, the teacher asked him to bring the tire back. He brought the flat tire back in the middle of the exam. Needless to say, the professor didn't expect that. The student had totally been partying, drives to school, takes off the tire, punctures it, and bobs your Auntie Mary. Don't even need to puncture it, just deflate it a bunch, and then after the exam, just fill it back up. Well, but I already punctured it. Well, then bobs your Auntie Mary. I had a 6-year-old turn up late to her lesson and blurted,
"Sorry, I was late, I had to color in a bunny."
It seems fair. I was about one of 20 kids who were late to school. We showed up at the school office as a group, and when questioned why we were late, we said, "The school bus blew up." They questioned, "So the engine blew up?" "No, the whole bus in flames. It blew up." There was much conference between the teachers, all of them thinking we embellished the story. The next thing you know, one of the admin staff has the news website open. A very obvious image of the entire bus on fire with a bunch of kids in our school uniforms standing in front of it. Our late slip for the class read, "School bus blew up." A guy in my college class missed one day. The next day, he came in with his eye cover up and medical paperwork in hand. Apparently, he got pecked in the eye by a chicken. In my hometown, if you walked into anywhere late and said the phrase, "Sorry, it was the grain train," you were never challenged. It was extremely common for 50-plus carriage trains to run through the middle of our town. We had the same thing in my hometown, except for the bridge was up. That bridge was notorious for not following a schedule and always being up when you're in a hurry. I was a student in this case. My neighbor had a really social goat, and she figured out how to escape her pen in order to come over and hang out. She escaped and followed me to the bus stop, and when the bus came, she tried to follow me onto it. I couldn't actually get in onto the bus without her being right behind me, so I had to get off, bring her home, and call my dad to bring me to school. My student had to take her sister to school and drive her mom to rehab. She was always late to class because her mom just wanted to sleep in. The problem was, if the mom was late or did not go, she would have violated her probation and gone to prison. I never marked her late. If she missed anything important, she would just come in at lunch or after school to make it up. Student here, I headed into school early to get some studying done in the library before my night class. I was one exit away when I was caught in a free car accident. Most of the expressway afterwards was gridlocked with only one lane left open. I did eventually make it into my lab class 15 minutes late with a few scrapes and bruises. My professor's reaction was simply, "Oh, that was you? Was he the one that hit you?" The kid on our team was late because someone stole his windshield wipers and it was snowing outside. He kept having to pull over to the side of the road and wipe off his windshield. In the UK, a student couldn't submit an assignment on time as the Wi-Fi was down on the megabus. That's pretty standard, to be honest. Wait, there's Wi-Fi in the megabus? Conceptually, yes. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave a comment and check out doodlingduck.com, where my girlfriend has made some amazing doodles.